Roth and Thomas Arne Roth. Both of them will be acting as pacemakers here. Andreas is a regular on the circuit. This is Thomas. You can see his personal best, 2:21. Hakon Musholm will also be in the race here, but it's Filip Ingebrigtsen who will be chasing the time. Now, the record that he's after is one which is well within his capability. It still stands to Vebjørn Rodal, great Norwegian hero of athletics, Olympic champion from 1996, 2:16.78. So that's the target here for Ingebrigtsen. He has a 1,000-meter personal best, which goes back to 2016, which was just outside that Norwegian record, 2:16.95. So one of the things you may not have seen before, it has been used in one or two places, but we're starting to think about using it a lot more in athletics. We'll be hoping to watch the pace being set, not only physically by the guys in the race for him, but by lights around the track. There you can see them. The green lights will be going at about the pace that we think is required. So he's aiming for about 27 seconds or so for a kind of even-paced race to bring him home around about the 2:15 mark. And Filip, in the press conference yesterday, said he feels like he's ready to go for this, and I think he's definitely capable of going under 2:16. But he will have to come back and take part in the 2,000 metres in just 45 minutes' time with his brothers and try to help them in that record attempt as well. So pretty good pace being set here at the front by Andreas Roth, his brother, just tucked in behind him there. A little bit of a gap to Ingebrigtsen, just sitting off it, maybe just sensing that they're going a little bit quick through this first 400 metres. The 1,000 metres are really brings together the 800 and the 1500 meter specialists, and you cannot really say that Filip Ingebrigtsen is an 800 specialist. His personal best is perhaps one of the towards the slow end of a world-class 1500 meter runner, man like him, a man who's run 3:30. So a little bit quick through 400 for him, but he's just settling into this now, and this is where it gets hard. You get to the bell, you've still got a lap to go. It'll be really interesting to see how far the pacemaker can go, but I doubt he'll go much beyond 600-700 meters at best. So it's going to be up to Ingebrigtsen now. 1:21, a 54 lap there, so that's pretty good through that point. So he only needs to, run about 54 and a half seconds for this last lap. Ingebrigtsen not yet getting going and just looking as though he's letting Rutt, who's putting in his last big effort as a pacemaker down the back straight as Musholm's had enough and steps off. Rutt still there, relaxed look on the face of Ingebrigtsen. And he's got to make a big bit through this last 200 metres by my reckoning there. He's still got well within his grasp here. Only needs to run 27-something through the last 200. Ingebrigtsen, what crowd there is, trying to give him some support here into these long home straights here in the Bislett Stadium. He's done this on many occasions in training and in racing as well. And don't forget the time he's looking for, the Norwegian record, 2:16.76. He's going to be very close to that, and he's done it! Well, not by very much in the end. The official time, 2:16.48. Well, that all happened in the last few strides. I thought he was heading for about 2:15. Wow. Well, that's a great start. A first record of the evening, a Norwegian record, wiping off the Olympic, former Olympic champion, Vebjørn Rodal's name from the Norwegian record list. That was hard work, though, and he's got to come back and do a bit more in the 2000 later. Be interesting to see how he recovers. He did say that part of his recovery would be a lap of honour, and he's having a bit of fun there, just trying to say, come on, where's the reception for my record? But he knows he's got more work to do this evening. So Ingebrigtsen with a new Norwegian record in the 1,000 metres, 2:16.46, just shaving that record, which is...